Hi guys, our topic for today is about prestressed concrete design. So, since it is a design subject, so katulad din siya ng reinforced concrete natin, our design for prestressed concrete can be designed using the working stress design and the ultimate strength design. So, for the introduction of the prestressed concrete, we'll be focusing first on determining the stresses acting on the topmost and the bottommost fiber of a prestressed concrete. So, bakit ganun yung kinoconsider natin? Remember, sabi nga natin kanina, meron tayong working stress at saka ultimate strength. So, for the working stress design, we all know that we are computing for the actual stresses acting on a given concrete system, and we will relate it doon sa allowable stresses provided by the code. So in case of the prestressed concrete, we have here in the Philippines, the National Structural Code of the Philippines. So nasa chapter 4 din yan kasama ng concrete. Then we also have the allowable stresses provided by ACI and the PCI, or the Prestressed Concrete Institute. Okay, so since working stress design focuses on comparing the actual stress against doon sa allowable stresses, it is essential na matutunan muna natin how do we compute for the actual stresses acting on our prestressed concrete. So, syempre, yung prestressed concrete natin, especially those na nakapag-work na in the industry, or yung mga students natin na nag-summer class, tapos nakapunta na sila sa mga site natin, prestressed concretes are most of the time precast, no? So, may mga commercial sizes na yun. But in the introduction, we will be focusing first on rectangular sections. Now, how do we compute for the stresses acting on the topmost and the bottommost fiber? By the way, we are computing for the topmost tsaka bottommost fiber ng stresses sa isang rectangular section ng concrete, ng prestressed concrete, because we all know in flexure, if we will be considering the stress at the neutral axis, it is zero. Tapos, papunta siya sa taas at saka sa baba, pataas ng pataas yung stress na dinadala nung material natin. So, meaning, when we are considering flexural stresses, maximum of stresses, it's either on the topmost or at the bottommost part of the beam section. So, paano daw nga natin siya kinocompute? So, meron tayong tinatawag na concepts of prestressing. So, there are three, no? The first one is what we call the basic concept method. The second one is what we call the C-line method. So later, let's study bakit ba siya tinawag na C-line, no? Then the third one is what we call the load balancing method. Okay. So these are the three concepts or the three methods that we will be using in determining the actual stresses at the topmost and the bottommost part of concrete. So let's discuss first, paano ba natin kinoconsider na ang isang concrete is subjected to a prestressing force. No? So for example, we have here a simply supported beam. Lagay natin yung cross-section niya. No? So, let's say ito yung rectangular na cross-section. So, obviously, meron tayong mga dimensions. Ito yung breadth natin or yung width. We have also the total height. Okay? So, we have, let's say this is the neutral axis. No? Okay, so a prestressed concrete is subjected to a prestressing force, which is actually considered as an axial force. Okay, so most of the time it is located below the neutral axis. So let's represent it to be APS. No, APS is the area of the prestressing tendons or the prestressing steel. Ang location niya from the neutral axis is what we call the eccentricity. Okay. The actual force acting on the concrete is what we call as we call the prestressing force or It is also termed as the jacking force. Okay. Next. So, drawing natin. Kunyari, i-drawing din natin yung side view, no? Nung beam natin. So, kunyari, ito yung magiging side view niya. Okay. The prestressing tendons can be applied if this is again your neutral axis, no? The prestressing tendons can be applied in what we call a straight tendons. So, pwede siyang, itong part na to, pwedeng diretso lang daw yung tendon natin. Okay. Or, pwede rin daw siya na draped. Pwede din siya na depressed. So, ibig sabihin, if this is your neutral axis, yung tendon natin pwede siyang pa-depress. So, ibig sabihin, hindi siya naka-straight line. So, pwedeng paganito yung prestressing tendon natin. So, ang tawag natin dito is parabolic. Or, tinatawag din natin na drape. No? Then, it can also be depressed pa rin, pero ang itsura ng tendons natin is straight line siya pababa. No? So, let's say straight line pababa. Ganyan. Tapos, straight line ulit dito. So, straight line to, unlike for the parabolic, it is of second degree curve. Ito, first degree curve. Yeah. Okay. So, ang tawag natin dito sa pinakambabang point are what we call the depression points. Okay. So, ang tawag natin dito is pwedeng straight depressed or tinatawag natin na harp tendons. No. Ano pinagkaiba nung dalawang to na depressed tendons doon sa straight? No? So, kapag straight po yung tendons, so, obviously, ibig sabihin, uniform po yung eccentricity niya all throughout the section of the beam, no? Pero kapag parabolic po, or draped, at saka kapag harp, iba yung eccentricity niya sa bawat section. Let's say this is E1, dito iba ulit yung eccentricity. Tapos dito, iba na naman yung eccentricity and so on and so forth. So, ibig sabihin, hindi siya uniform. Pwedeng, ang nangyayari sa eccentricity natin, siya po ay palaki ng palaki, mula papunta sa gitna, tapos paliit ulit ng paliit. Ganon din po for the depression points. No? Ngayon, when we will be discussing pre-stress, sige, let's discuss. Bakit, alin ang mas okay? Is it the straight tendons or the depressed tendons? No? So, if we will be considering simply supported beams, it's better to use depressed tendons, either parabolic or harp. Anong reason behind that, no? Kasi po, as we all know, no, if we will be dealing with simply supported, the main purpose of the prestressing tendons is actually for you to have, number one, a greater capacity for flexure, and number two, for you to have a longer span. Okay? So, ang ibig sabihin kasi nun, the prestressing tendons will produce a negative moment. Okay? So, paano ko nasabi na magpo-produce siya ng negative moment? Sige, lagay natin dito sa part ng paper na to. No? So, normally kasi, kung meron po akong simply supported, tapos meron po akong gravity load, ang itsura po ng moment diagram niyan is paganto, which will always produce a positive moment. Okay, so ano po magiging itsura ng bending? So obviously, it will have an elastic curve that is pasmile. Okay, however, if you will be putting a pre-stressing force below the neutral axis, sa tingin nyo, ano yung magiging itsura ng curve ng beam natin? Kunyari, ito. Okay, so na-imagine nyo ba? If we will be putting a force below the neutral axis, it will make your beam deflect upward. Thus, it will actually produce a negative moment. So in that case, it's actually somewhat counteracting with the positive moment provided by the gravity loads. So in that case, ibig sabihin pala, kung pag-uusapan natin yung moment or flexure capacity of the beam, the pre-stressing force actually gives you a larger capacity of moment or flexure. In that case, remember, for simply supported, if you have a uniform load, ano bang formula natin for a simply supported given a uniformly distributed load with length L? So, it is actually equal to WL squared over 8. So, ibig sabihin, moment equals WL squared over 8. Meaning, moment is actually a function of the uniform load W and the length L. Meaning, since you will be having a greater flexure capacity or moment capacity of the beam caused by the pre-stressing tendons, it is either you can increase the load, the uniform load capacity of the beam, or you can place the same uniform load pero of longer span. Kasi nga sabi natin that the moment capacity, that the moment equation or the moment formula is dependent on the uniform load at saka ng length L. Kasi sabi natin, moment equals WL squared over 8. So, ibig sabihin, kung constant yung W, pwede mong lakihan yung L kasi lumaki yung M natin, yung M capacity. Or, dahil lumaking M capacity, tas gusto mo constant yung L, pwedeng yung uniform load W yung lalakihan natin. So, yun yung actually yung one of the main purpose why we are using pre-stress or pre-stressing force, no, sa concrete natin. Number one, for us to have a larger gravity load, okay, pwedeng increase natin yung live load ng beam na yun, or lakihan natin yung span. Most of the time, kung papansin nyo, kapag, for example, for bridges, tapos, for example, you will be putting a bridge between a river, no? Tapos yung width ng river na yun, sobrang haba. So, dati, in the Philippines, no? Nung hindi pa ganun ka-uso yung paggamit ng pre-stress concrete, you will be, for example, let's say, 10 or 12 meters na width ng river. Okay, so usually, mapipilitan si... kung concrete yung gagamitin natin, kung normal na reinforced concrete yung gagamitin natin, normally, ang mangyayari is, magkakaroon po ako ng column sa gitna when we construct that bridge. No? Pero, when we'll be using a pre-stressed concrete, it can actually support that 10 to 12 meters. So, pwedeng wag na tayong maglagay ng column. So, paano kung malalim nga naman yung river o kaya yung riverbed niya masyadong malambot, yung soil dun, tas malalim yung bedrock, no? So, maganda kung pinag-aaralan yun, tapos kung pwedeng solution doon is to provide or to use a pre-stress concrete. No? So, yun yung essence natin or one of the reasons why we are using pre-stress concrete. Okay, now, so balik tayo dito sa question ko. Bakit ko sinabi na mas okay yung depressed tendons, yung pababa, yung tendons, kaysa doon sa straight line lang? Okay, kasi nga, sabi natin dito, kung mapapansin nyo, if you have a varying load, no? Distributed load, tapos ang magiging moment mo is positive, as you can see, the moment diagram is not uniform. Saan siya pinakamataas? Di ba sa gitna? Okay, so dahil sa gitna yung pinakamataas niya, ibig sabihin, mas maganda kung ika-counteract natin yung moment na yan, yung pinakamataas sa gitna, tapos papunta sa gilid, maliit na counteracting moment lang. So, paano ba natin siya nakaka-counteract? Paano ko ba nasabi kanina na kung mag-apply ako ng pre-stressing force dito, automatic, it will produce a negative moment? Obviously, no? Kasi nga, for example, I will apply here a pre-stressing force. So, sabi naman natin sa statics, di ba? Any force provided with a perpendicular distance will produce a moment. So, in this case, this force with an eccentricity e distance papunta dun sa neutral axis will actually provide a moment, no, about the neutral axis. And that moment is actually a negative moment. Meaning, yung force P times eco will counteract the moment produced by the gravity loads. Okay? So, saan ngayon nakadepende yung counteracting moment ko? Diba sa force P at saka sa E? Okay? Anong mapapansin nyo kung constant yung tendon, kung straight line? Ibig sabihin, equal yung negative moment ko dito, equal yung counteracting moment ko dito, equal yung counteracting moment ko dito. Pero if you will be using a draped tendon at saka a harp tendon, iba yung counteracting moment ko dito, iba yung counteracting moment ko dito, iba yung counteracting moment ko dito sa part na to. Bakit? Because the eccentricity E distance, which is the moment arm of the counteracting moment, is varying. Ibig sabihin, iba-iba, depende po sa location na kinoconsider natin. Which is actually, for us, will be economical in that case. No? Bakit? Kasi, kung papansin nyo, hindi ko naman kailangan mag-counteract ng malaking moment sa part na to. Eh, kasi maliit lang yung moment. So, dapat habang papunta ko ng papunta sa gitna, palaki ng palaki yung counteracting moment ko. And in that case, kung mapapansin nyo sa dalawang drawing na to, palaki ng palaki yung eccentricity ko mula sa gilid papunta dun sa gitna. That's why, for me, when we are designing prestressed concrete, it's better to use a draped or a harp tendon. Meaning, it's better to use a depressed tendon. Okay? Okay na? Okay. So, let's discuss paano ba gagamitin tong tatlong formula na to. So, let's have first the basic concept method. So, number one. Basic concept method. So, again, let's consider again, ito yung simply supported beam natin. So, meron yang load. It will produce a moment, no? Positive moment. Okay. So, lagay ulit natin dito yung cross-section. Again, this is your B. This is H. Tapos, ito yung APS natin, no? Okay. So, what are the forces? Pag sinabi naman kasi natin we are computing for the stresses, ang ginagawa lang natin is just to determine the stresses acting on the beam system. Pero bago natin ma-determine yung stresses, ano-ano ba yung mga forces na nag-a-act doon? No? So obviously, we have what we call the uniform load. Tapos pangalawa, yung pre-stressing force. Wala nang iba. Okay, yung dalawa lang na yun. So focus muna tayo doon sa uniform load. Okay, so idiretso ko to ha, para drawing natin lahat ng stress diagram. So, focus muna tayo dun sa given na uniform load. So, drawing ko yung flexural stress diagram. Kung meron po akong positive moment, what will happen, what type of flexural stress yung mapuproduce ko sa uppermost part tsaka sa bottommost part? So, sabi natin, a positive moment makes the beam smile. Kapag nag-smile yung beam ko, obviously, the upmost part or the part of the concrete above the neutral axis will be subjected to compression, and yung bottom most part will be subjected to tension. And remember, since it is a flexural stress diagram, ang magiging formula po niyan is M C over I, where C is the distance from the neutral axis to the topmost fiber. Let's say it is C top. Tapos, this is C bottom, meaning the distance of the neutral axis papunta dun sa pinakambabang fiber. Okay? Ano pa? So, sabi natin, maliban dun sa gravity loads na naka-apply sa beam natin, it is also subjected to what we call the pre-stressing force. Remember that the pre-stressing force is an actual force acting perpendicular to the cross-section, meaning kung ito yung cross-section, nag-a-act siya perpendicular sa mukha mismo nung beam natin. And in that case, since it is an actual force, we'll be having two type of stresses. Bakit? Una, kung actual force yan, magkakaroon ako ng actual stress. Pangalawa, since that actual force is not acting on the centroid but below the neutral axis, it will produce also an additional flexural stress. So, dun muna tayo sa actual stress. So, kung dahil magpo-produce siya ng actual stress, obviously, ang actual stress po is actually a stress that is uniform, no? Acting on the cross-section. Meaning, negative yan. all throughout. No? And the formula is just equal to P over A. Remember the signs, huh? We will be adding it later. No? Okay? And last is another flexural stress produced by the pre-stressing force. Dahil wala nga siya sa gitna. So magkakaroon siya ng moment na force P times E. Okay? So this is baliktad naman. Since it is a negative moment, it is under tension sa taas, under compression sa baba. But the formula is still MC over I. But however, please remember na yung moment caused by the pre-stressing force is P times E. No? Okay. So as you can see, parang lang pala ma-determine ko yung stress sa top, i-add ko lang lahat ng stresses sa top. Para ma-determine ko yung stresses sa bottom, kailangan ko lang i-add yung stress sa bottom. So meaning, ang ginagawa lang natin is parang strema, ang tawag natin doon is combined loadings, no? Or combined stresses. Ibig sabihin, pinagsama lang natin yung stresses acting on the given section. So ano-ano yun? So let's start first with ito, MC over I. Ibig sabihin, yung force daw, yung stress daw sa top, i-add ko lang lahat ng nasa top. So that is negative MC over I, negative ulit, so negative P over A, tapos positive. Ah, sorry, hindi na pa nakita. Ayan, positive. So plus PEC over I. Okay? But we can simplify this equation actually, no? So, kung papansin nyo, itong dalawa parehas may P, no? We can actually simplify it, no? By using a term, no? In our statics of rigid bodies, it is known as the radius of gyration. So, the radius of gyration is just actually the square root of the ratio between the moment of inertia and the area of the cross-section. So, in that case, R squared is just equal to I over A, or I is equal to AR squared. So we can actually substitute it here. Ayusin natin, yung stress sa top is equal to, unahin ko ngayon to, no? We have negative P over A, then plus PEC, tapos gagawin ko tong AR squared minus MC over I. Okay. So we can actually factor out yung negative P over A, meaning the stress at the top is actually equal to negative P over A multiplied by, so magiging 1 na lang to, negative, so magiging negative to, matitira po dito is EC. So para ma-identify natin kung anong value ng C yung i-consider natin, meron tayong dalawang C, diba? Isang C top tsaka isang C bottom. So, top yung kinoconsider natin. We will be using C top over R squared. Anong natira dito? So, palitan na rin natin to, no? So, yung I over C is actually equal to what we call the elastic section modulus, or simply section modulus, no? So, this is minus M over S. So, top yung kinoconsider natin. Likewise, kung bottom lang naman yung kinoconsider natin, yung stress sa bottom, ano lang ba yung nag-iba na stress? No? Itong dalawa lang. So, magpapalit lang daw yung sign. Magpapalit lang daw yung sign nito at saka nito. So, magiging negative to, ito magiging positive. So, ito magiging positive, positive. So, that will give you negative P over A multiplied by 1 plus E. Ang kinoconsider natin is the bottom part divided by R squared plus M over S bottom. So these two formulas are actually the formula to be used using the basic concept method. Okay? Now, based on the basic concept method, meron tayong dapat tandaan, no? So meron tayong tinatawag na dalawang condition when we are computing for the stresses. Conditions on stresses. Isingit natin dito. Okay. Number one, meron tayong tinatawag na initial condition. initial or a transfer condition. Okay, pangalawa, ang tawag natin dun is at service condition. Sir, ano po yung dalawang condition na to? So, what are these two conditions? So, when we say at initial or transfer condition, ibig sabihin, it is actually a situation in which the pre-stressing force is just applied. So, kaka-apply lang ng pre-stressing force doon sa concrete natin. Saan po yun ginagawa? So, usually, ginagawa po yun syempre doon sa production natin. So, sa production area. Meaning, at the production area, we all know, lagay natin dito, no? Lagay natin ng yan, ng table, para hindi tayo nalilito. Ano ba yung kinoconsider natin, no? So, parameters na i-consider natin. Pag sinabi natin at service condition, ibig sabihin, yung pre-stressing force ko initial yon, meaning may subscript na I. Kasi at initial or at transfer condition. Pangalawa, dahil nasa factory pa, or sorry, nasa planta pa yung concrete natin, meaning, hindi pa siya dinadaanan ng sasakyan natin if it's a bridge. Meaning, ang or ang gravity load lang na dinadala niya is just actually the self weight. Okay, so let's define, no? Yung pag may subscript na D, it is considered as a self weight. Pag may subscript na SD, it is superimposed dead load. And when we say WL, obviously, live load yung subscript. Okay? So, ano pa? Okay? So, dahil self-weight lang to, obviously, yung moment na mapoproduce caused by the uniform load or gravity load is just also the self-weight. Okay? However, if it's a service condition, meron tayong tinatawag na P subscript. This is a subscript. E, meaning effective pre-stressing force. Lagay natin, effective. Ito po ay initial. Okay, so when we say effective, nabawas na po natin lahat ng losses. Obviously, when we are using machines, no? When we are applying a force, there are what we call losses, no? Meron tayong immediate, at saka meron tayong time-dependent losses. So, we will be discussing it in our later videos, no? Paano ba natin kinocompute yung mga time-dependent losses natin? So, meaning, to determine the effective pre-stressing force, it's just the initial pre-stressing force minus all the losses. So, yun yung tinatawag natin na effective pre-stressing force. And their relationship is actually the ratio between the effective and the initial pre-stressing force is just actually equal to gamma. Okay? Yung gamma na yan, ang tawag natin dyan, is the pre-stress residual factor. Okay? So, ano pa? Yung parameters na kinoconsider natin at service condition. So, we also have, obviously, total na yung weight na kinoconsider natin. So, obviously, total moment na yung mapoproduce natin. Okay? So, that is how we derive the basic concept method. Okay? So, yung other videos natin, doon natin i-discuss kung paano naman na-derive si C-line method at saka si load balancing method. So for now, we will end the video with the derivation of the basic concept method. So meaning, let's have a recap. Ang ginawa lang naman natin for this discussion is we discussed the concepts of pre-stressing, the three concepts of pre-stressing, then what are the different tendon path, okay? Or kung paano natin we can use the term layout, no? Tendon layout. Okay, then why do we use prestressed concrete? So yun yung na-discuss natin in this video. So to continue our discussion for the C-line and the load balancing method, we will be having a separate videos for that. So if I were you, if you want to watch the other videos, click subscribe and hit the bell button para so that you can be notified right after na ma-upload natin yung video natin. So see you on our next video.